I hate to be the one to say it, but STL sucks. That file format that you're probably using for your 3D printer is actually holding 3D printing back. However, there is an alternative. It's just that no one's using it. It's called 3MF. 1987 was, by any measure, a good year. Theatergoers were getting to watch The Princess Bride, the best movie of all time. NES players were playing the first Mega Man game, the best video game series of all time. And 3D Systems, founded by Chuck Hull, the father of 3D printing, needed a way to store the three-dimensional shape of an object for their brand new stereolithography 3D printer. They called the format STL after the stereolithography 3D printer it was created for. Now, the idea of 3D in the computer space wasn't entirely new, even in 1987. Some early explorations of 3D can be seen in early vector games like Battlezone in 1980, and a few examples even before that. These early games figured out that a single triangle in 3D could be defined by the 3D coordinate points x, y, and z of each of the corners. Now, put enough of these triangles together, and you've got a shape. And that's really all that an STL file was. It's a list of all the corners of every triangle that makes up a shape. Just like you can convey the content of a book with a text file, technically, a text file lacks formatting data, so you couldn't do like a full page yes, like in the Discworld novel Reaper Man. Oh, sorry, spoilers if you haven't read it, but look it up. It's hilarious. STL also lacks some crucial information. For instance, there's no scale information in an STL. So while it may say that a corner is at X3, Y2, Z4, that's three what in real life? 3 inches or meters or three Oliver R. Smoots laid end to end? At the time, the unspoken convention was to interpret these units as millimeters, but when the format was adopted by Autodesk, an American company, they used whatever measurement standard that the designer was using at the time, which was usually inches. And there's nothing in an STL to communicate that this file's in millimeters and this file's in inches, and sometimes that comes around to bite you. As 3D computer graphics became more prominent, there needed to be a way to store not just a shape, but data about the color of a shape, and a new format was created to do this. The OBJ format contains not only the shape, but, quote, facet-specific color and material data. Essentially, you could wallpaper a 3D shape with a 2D image. But OBJ didn't keep that color data in the OBJ file itself. It kept a separate file called an MTL file and links to it. And any of the 2D images that are being wallpapered are also separate files that the MTL is supposed to keep track of. So we've got an OBJ that needs to keep track of the MTL, and the MTL that needs to keep track of the image files, and all of these need to be kept together by the user, and you can't change the file names, or the parent file won't be able to find them anymore. And if you forget to attach one of those files, the whole thing could fall apart. And on top of it all, OBJ still didn't keep track of the scale that an object was in. Now, while there are relatively few 3D printing processes that can use the color data of an OBJ file, when they do, they have to use an OBJ to store it, or rather they did. But that's why most slicers for FFF 3D printers will read in an OBJ file no problem. They'll just discard that color data. But clearly, we need a way to store our digital objects specific for 3D printing that's better than STL or OBJ. And we do. It's called 3MF, which stands for 3D Manufacturing File. Now, there's no one company who made this format, but many companies like Autodesk and Netfab are now on the 3MF consortium helping to define it. 3MF contains the 3D model, just like an STL file does. It can also contain texture data, just like an OBJ. And it also contains other data, like, finally, the unit scale. It can contain information about the manufacturing process that the file was designed for, information about who designed it, a description, copyright information, license term. It can even contain a thumbnail image for a quick preview of the object. Honestly, it's awesome, and it keeps it all in one file, so you no longer have to keep track of multiple files and keep them all in the same place and don't rename. Forget about all of that. 3MF keeps track of it all. And even better, chances are your slicer already reads 3MF files right now. So why aren't more 3D files being distributed as 3MF? Why are we all still using STL? Well, for one, 3MF is really fairly new, especially when compared to the granddaddy of STL. And 3MF has its criticisms. It's potentially very complex and maybe contains too much information. This makes it difficult to write an exporter for it. But I think the biggest reason we don't have repositories full of 3MF files probably has to do with exporting designs as 3MF. There are very few CAD programs, none of the ones which I regularly use, that can natively export 3MF. When I make my 3MF files, I have to export an OBJ with its MTL and image files, and then package them all together with 3D Builder, which fortunately comes with Windows 10. Still, it's cumbersome, and it's an additional step that I can see designers not being willing to put up with. Fusion 360, Blender, Tinkercad, Sculptress, ZBrush, all of these need to add native 3MF support immediately, if not sooner, because I really like 3MF, and I want to let go of STL as soon as I can. What do you think? Do we need 3MF right now? Or are we doing okay with what we have? And what do you like to do your designs in? Does it support 3MF? If you believe in 3MF like I do, reach out to the programmers of your favorite CAD program and tell them you want 3MF support. Then let me know how it went. Maybe in a year, the last half of this video will be completely wrong as everyone adopts this great new standard. You know what it's like. You see a cool new filament and you want to try it out, but as you're hovering over that buy button, you remember the last three spools of fancy filament that you bought, used for that one thing, and haven't used since. It sounds like you need the 3D Printing Professor Filament of the Month Club. Each month you'll receive a generous coil of just the good stuff, enough to work with it, but not so much that you'll feel guilty later. Thanks, 3D Printing Professor. Wait, that's me. Join the Filament of the Month Club today.
Thank you very much for watching. Hey, if I mentioned anything in this video, you'll find a link to it in the cards, and you should check that out. Did you know that I'm social? I've got links to all the socials, and you should stop by and say hi. I really kind of enjoy it when that happens. Big thanks go out to my direct backers, and if you want to know more about how you can become that, there'll be a link right here that you can check out. And as always, I want to remind you, safety first, because I care about you. And I'll see you next time. Oh, that's interesting. Classic one there.